Hello students, hope you all are doing well. So as you know, we are doing division chapter. So today our topic is division using multiplication tables. Okay, so first sum is divide using multiplication tables. So suppose this sum is given, 30 divided by 5 is equal to what? So students, if you remember that this term is called dividend, this term is called divisor. So this number which is to be divided, that is called dividend, and with which number we are dividing, that is called divisor. So this number we are supposed to find. So what is this number called? That is quotient. So basically in this sum we are supposed to find quotient. Okay, so how we will find? So we will find its quotient by using multiplication tables. So students, for these sums, for this chapter, you should know the tables. So for that, please daily do written practice of tables. Take any five tables, write those tables twice in a day. Okay, you can copy that table, don't cram the tables. Okay, so the sum is given 30 divided by 5. So how we can find our quotient? So we will write the divisors table. Okay, so what is divisor here? 5. So recall 5's table. 5 1's are 5, 5 2's are 10. Till which number we will write the table? Until we get 30 in answer. Okay, so 5 1's are 5, 5 2's are 10, 5 3's are 15, 5 4's are 20, 5 5's are 25, 5 6 are 30. So we get our dividend here, 30. So 5 is our divisor. So which will be our quotient? 6. How many times 5 is 30? 6 times. So 6 will be your quotient. So by using tables, you will find the quotient. I hope it is clear to all. Okay, next is find the divisor. Now here you found the quotient and here we will find the divisor. So statement is 48 divided by which number that we get quotient as 6. The method is same to do this sum. Now we will recall 6 table. Okay, so 6 1's are 6, 6 2's are 12, 6 3's are 18, 6 4's are 24, 6 5's are 30, 6 6's are 36, 6 7's are 42, 6 8's are 48. So our dividend is 48. So 6 8's are 48. It means which number will be divisor? Because this is quotient, this is dividend, both are given. So this is divisor, so 8 will be here. So 48 should be divisible with 8 to get 6. So all these sums are tables based. Okay, so third is mixture of these two sums. Somewhere you have to find quotient and in other sum you have to find divisor. Okay, so 72 divisible with 12. So it means we will recall 12's table. You must know 12's table. Okay, so first 12 1's are 12, 12 2's are 24, 12 3's are 36, 12 4's are 48, 12 5's are 60, 12 6's are 72. So it means 12 6 are 72. Okay, so next you can write here tables in rough work. So next is 30 divided with which number, so that we get 6 as answer. So we will recall 6 table. 6 1s are 6, 6 2s are 12, 6 3s are 18, 6 4s are 24, 6 5s are 30. So 6 5s are 30. Okay. Next is compare and put greater sign, smaller sign or equality sign in box. Okay, your sum is given like this: 2 multiplied by 4, then 72 divided with 8. So you have to compare that which side is bigger and which side is smaller. So for this, first you will solve both the sides. So how to solve? 2 multiplied by 4 means 2 fours are 8. Now 72 divided by 8, this you will do with this method. Okay, so 72 divided with 8 means 8's table. So 8 9's are 72. So it means their answer will be 9. So 8 is smaller than 9. So you will put here smaller sign. I take here second example. 64 divided with 8, 5 multiplied with 0. So you have to compare both the sides. So we will solve here both the sides. So 8 8s are 64, and you know any number multiplied with 0 is always 0. Okay, so 8 is smaller or bigger than 0? 8 is bigger than 0. So I hope it's clear to all. Thank you.